A wastewater is to be disinfected with 35 milligrams per liter of chlorine to obtain 99% kill of microorganisms. The number of microorganisms remaining alive at any time T is modeled by NT is equal to N0 e power minus KT, where N0 is number of microorganisms at T is equal to 0, K is the rate of kill, and the wastewater flow rate is 36 meter cube per hour and K is equal to 0.23 meter inverse if the depth and width of the chlorination tank are 1.5 meters and 1 meters respectively, the length of the tank rounded off to 2 decimals. So the number of microorganisms killed is at any time is given as number of microorganisms remaining alive at given as NT is equal to N0 e power minus KT. Number of microorganisms at T is equal to 0 and number of microorganisms at any time T. He said that 99% efficiency of killing organisms means how many microorganisms that is left? 1% of microorganisms is left at any time T. If I say in order to obtain 99% of kill of microorganisms, so that means at the final stage, let us say at time T, the number of microorganisms should be present is 1%. Initially, how many microorganisms will be present? 100%. So NT is equal to N0 e power K is given as 0.23 into T. Meter inverse 0.23 is given to you. This is 1 by 100 e power minus 0.23 into T. T after substituting, you will get it as 20 minutes. Now discharge is given to you. Flow rate. Discharge is given to you as 36 meter cube per hour. So volume of the tank that is required would be the discharge into detention time. This is actual detention time, means if chlorination is done for 20 minutes, 99% of organisms will be killed. That is the idea of it. So this is 36 meter cube per hour, 20 by 60. You will get this in meter cube. Now once if you get volume, L into B into H is equal to 12. LBH is equal to 12. Whereas L you have to calculate. Width is given to you. Depth and width of the tank. Width is 1 meter. Depth is 1.5 meters. That is 12. L is equal to 12 by 3 by 2. That is 8 meters. This is how you will calculate the length of the sedimentation tank. So idea is very simple. Calculate the time required or detention period for which the chlorination is to be done by using this equation. Once if you get that, you will get the volume of the tank. Once if you get the volume of the tank, you can calculate the length of the tank. That's it. Thank you.